Okay, have you ever wondered how you could write the equivalent of a Watson program or a Siri program for your own computer? Just imagine if you could talk to your machine in terms of stories. Simple stories, perhaps just one-sentence stories like Ashok ate a frog. Now, we have already seen how a machine can make sense of this particular sentence, Ashok ate a frog. We did that last time. But of course, eat or ate can occur in many, many different ways in sentences. Here are some of the other ways in which I can use the verb eat. Ashok ate out at a restaurant. I could tell something was really eating him. Now, the sense of eating him here is very different from the sense of eating here. There is no physical object that is being eaten here. The manager would rather eat the losses. So now this is a very different notion of eat. The river gradually ate away at the riverbank, yet another notion of eat. So just like we had in the previous lesson, take, the word take, which had so many different meanings, eat has so many different meanings. Now, when we were discussing the word take, we discussed how we can use both the structure of sentences as well as background knowledge to disambiguate between different interpretations of take. We could do something similar with eat. We could enumerate all the different meanings of eat, and then for each meaning of eat, we could ask ourselves, what is it about the structure of the sentence, and what is it about the background knowledge that I have about things like rivers and river banks, which tells me what the meaning of eat here is. To summarize this part, if you were to start talking to your machine in stories, in terms of simple stories designated by a single sentence, then one problem that will occur is that words like eat or take will have large number of meanings. And we have seen how your machine can be programmed in such a way so as to disambiguate between different kinds of meanings of the same word. Now, here is a different problem that occurs. Consider a number of stories again. Each story here is designated by a single sentence. Ashok ate a frog, Ashok devoured a frog, Ashok consumed a frog, Ashok ingested a frog, and so on. Several sentences here. Now, if you think about it a little bit, each of these sentences is using a different verb, but the meaning of each of these verbs in these sentences is pretty much the same. So that Ashok ingested a frog, or Ashok devoured a frog, or Ashok dined on a frog, practically the same thing happened in each case. There was a frog which was initially outside Ashok's body, and then Ashok ate it up, and at the end the frog was inside Ashok's body, and the frog was dead, and Ashok was happy. So the next challenge becomes, how can a machine understand that the meaning of each of these words here is exactly the same? In a way, this problem is the inverse of the problem that we had here. Here the problem was that we had a single word, like eat, which had a lot of different meanings in different contexts and different sentences. Here, the issue is that we have a lot of different words, but they have the same meaning given the context of the sentences. So another question then becomes, well, how can we make machines understand that the meaning of these words in these sentences is exactly the same? Each of the sentences is telling us exactly the same story. There is one other thing that is important here, and that is the notion of context. One of the hardest things in AI is, how do we bring context into account? In both of these cases, context is playing an important role. On the left side, context is playing an important role because we understand that the meaning of eat is different in these different sentences because the context of eat is different. Here, context is playing a different role. We understand that the meaning of each of these words is practically the same because the context here is practically the same. A couple of quick qualifications here. First, right now we're dealing with stories that have just one sentences. Very soon, in the next lesson, we'll deal with stories which are much more complicated, which really have a series of sentences. For now, just simple stories. The second is that here the structure of all of these sentences is the same, so a structure practically tells us something about the context. But the situation is a lot more complicated because often two sentences which have very different kind of structures can still have the same meaning. So consider these two stories, Bob shot Bill. And Bob killed Bill with a gun. Now here the sentence structures are very different, but their interpretations, their meaning are the same. Bill was the one who got killed, Bob was the one who did the killing, and the killing was done by putting a bullet into Bill. So the question now becomes, how can we build AI agents that can meaningfully understand stories like this one, and stories of the kind that Bob shot Bill and Bob killed Bill with a gun? One thing we could do is that for each of the verbs here, we could have a frame like we had a frame for take. So we could have a frame for ate, a frame for devour, a frame for consume, a frame for ingested, and so on. Well, we would have a lot of frames then, because there are a large number of verbs in the English language or in any other modern language. Perhaps we could do something different. Perhaps we could look that there is a similarity between the interpretation of these things. Perhaps we could use the same primitive action for each one of them. So when we talk in English language, we might use for communication purposes all of these words. But perhaps we could build AI agents that have a single internal representation for each one of them. What might that internal representation look like? We will call that internal representation a primitive action. Each one of these is an action, but many of these actions are equivalent in terms of our interpretation of those actions. Let's see what these primitive actions might look like.